Right now, we're gonna show you the other things that make bok unique, right? So, ito. It became a trend here in the country, or maybe in Korea also, Korean corn dogs, right? So, malalaki yun. So, we had an idea na gawa kaya tayong own variants of corn dogs. Let's call it corn dog bites para many people can share. Because in bok, it's all about sharing, right? So here we have our best-selling corn dogs. So they come in sausage and mozzarella. Okay? So Chef Ems will explain how the corn dogs are made. So here.
So madali lang, no? This one. So yon. Binabalot namin si sausage do sa aming dough premix. All right? So around 25 to 30 grams, and then yon niroll namin siya sa breadcrumbs. So i-dip na siya sa oil.
Customers want something else aside from chicken, right? We needed to, of course, expand our menu to address the other needs of the customers. So again, this is going with the trend, which is, I think, a fundamental business practice na, diba? So this was supposedly just a trend, but because of its success, we kept it as a permanent menu item. So dito, pinapar fry lang natin. This is just partially fried. Then we will...
It's more on 80% cooked. Para pa dito sa store naman, dun ang final cooking sa store level.
Yep. So after frying, we will freeze this in the blast freezer.
Yes, correct.
So the corn dog business as is was also an emerging trend, I think, early last year. We wanted to ride with it, but at the same time, we didn't want to be dependent on it. That's why we decided to have very small corn dogs talaga. And I think this is a unique thing about us. Yeah. Kami lang yung nagbebenta ng corn dog bites. Ako, personally, nauumay ako sa malaking corndog. Hindi ko kaya na ubusin yung malaki. So, parang sabi ko, tara, share na lang. Gawa tayo 4 pieces per order. Okay, so, the corndog business, of course, this is just one of our side SKUs, which is a good pair to our boneless fried chicken. Right? Corndog as a business, I think, is a very easy and lucrative opportunity. Right? Here in the Philippines, hindi masyadong sikat yung corndog. Because, I don't know why. Pero, it's very, very easy to make. As you can see, it only consists of 3 ingredients. Our chicken sausage, our batter, and of course, breadcrumbs. Right? So, you can easily make this at home. Gawa ka lang ng batter, corn dog. It's very easy to Google. Right? You coat it. Then, you fry it. Then, maybe profit-wise, of course, just take note again that for food businesses, we try to always double our costs. So if the cost of this is around maybe 30 pesos to make, maybe you can sell it for around 60 to 80 pesos, right? So in this case, bok sells this for, I think, around 189 pesos to 219 pesos, okay? But that's for 4 pieces already. So this was a good basket size adder. Prior to the launch of corn dogs, we had an average basket size of around maybe 550 pesos. But after adding the corn dog SKU, of course, people started buying it and we started adding it to our combos. Tumaas yung basket size namin to around 680 to maybe 700 pesos. Okay? So if you have a business, of course, don't rely on that one SKU. Like, we have a successful SKU, which is chicken, right? But of course, nauumay rin yung tao. Gusto nila something else. So that's why we came up with this. And from then, it's been a big success. So ito, this is the dye that we use to differentiate yung sausage sa cheese. So kung nakita mo tong red, ibig sabihin sausage yan. So kung walang red, that means mozzarella. Mozzarella corndog. Kasi naman usually what we discuss as a board is we have to find the fine line between running a sustainable business and running a trendy business, right? So trendy business usually they would die after maybe 6 to 12 months, right? Because of lack of innovation, diba? So in Bok, we always make it a point to innovate. We always make it a point to improve, right? Do continuous research and develop our products para hindi kami maiiwan ng market. So currently, we sell boneless Korean fried chicken. Maybe in the near future, we sell boned-in fried chicken na. Diba? Kasi there's a market also for people who like boned fried chicken. So, ako personally, I like drumsticks. Kasi ang juicy ng bone eh. Diba? So maybe in the near future, Bok might sell that in Korea. Ganun talaga yung Korean fried chicken. May buto talaga. Okay? So, that's a good way para hindi maiwan ng market. Of course, try to adapt to everyone, but at the same time, do it on a sustainable basis. Don't get too ahead of yourselves. At the same time, don't fall back behind. So, ito na yung end product natin for our mozzarella corn dog. Okay? So, as you can see, we cooked it until golden brown for 2 minutes and 30 seconds. So, let's now do our cheese pull test to see kung okay ba. So, dapat mahila natin to. So,
ooh. Wow!
Our next product, which is which was just released recently, is our K spaghetti, or Korean style spaghetti, or our kimchi spaghetti. So, naturally, malamang sa mga Pinoy, unang tanong ng mga mommy na may kasamang anak, may spaghetti po ba kayo? So, dati wala, but of course, sabi ko kay Chef Ems, Chef, dumadami na yung mga dine-in customers natin. Lumalabas na yung mga tao, kasama ng mga pamilya. Pinoys want spaghetti. But how do we incorporate it in a Korean way? Diba? Idadagdagan natin ng kimchi. Right? So, from the start, medyo parang like, ha? Kimchi spaghetti? Parang like, medyo weird yun. Pero, tikman nyo, sobrang sarap nito. Okay. So, we came up with this kimchi spaghetti or K-style spaghetti, of course, to meet the demands of the Filipino consumers and customers, right? So we target particularly the families who have small children, but at the same time, we have to disclaim that it's kind of spicy, diba?
Yeah. Then we add the chopped red onion.
Kasi spaghetti is a staple for all Filipino restaurants, eh. Even kung tutusin mo sa KFC, even if their main product is chicken, mayroon silang spaghetti. For the Filipinos, of course, we love our spaghetti. So, the spaghetti that we developed is somewhat spicy, but also has a little bit of sweetness. Diba? Kasi yun yung hilig natin eh. Bok is the only Korean fried chicken company right now that
offering kimchi spaghetti.
Yep. So, although baka hindi familiar sa kimchi or Korean style spaghetti, rest assured, it's very, very delicious. Sobrang sarap niya. In our corporate office, we have an inventory manager which does the purchasing. So, pinaplanan nila yung demand for the week. So, tapos magpo-purchase order kami dito para yun yung ipro-produce na ano. So, kanyari, nag-order siya ng 20 packs of yangnyeon, which is 40 kilos. So, natin. Ito, dito makai siya. We'll consolidate all of the orders para yun yung i-produce natin. This is our kimchi spaghetti, K-style spaghetti.